You guys don't have anything in your car that's louder?
Just my car.
We see the story of Jesus going to the cross, and everything seems to kind of be hand in hand. And then there's this one character that seems to interrupt the narrative. His name's Barabbas. You don't even know much about him except that he's a murderer, a leader of an insurrection, a rebel. And why he's even mixed, sometimes I'm not so sure. So in this moment, Pilate thinks, I hold the destinies of these two men.
Yeah, right.
I know the Jews have a tradition that on a holy day,
it's released in the frequencies.
I will release one of the prisoners on death row. Pilate stands on this audacious stage, who now presents Jesus, Son of the Living God, versus Barabbas, the thug and rebel. He says, all right, who do you want? This is blasphemy. This has gone too far. There's no comparison. This is a rightful prisoner. A man who should be on death row. He's a rebel against Rome. He leads a rebellion. He murders people. He's a bad man. He's a thug and he's a crook. He deserves the chains and he deserves the crucifixion. Jesus? What has he done but heal, restore, deliver, set free, open blind eyes, open deaf ears, heal the lame and the leper? What has Jesus done? Who do you want? Who do you want, Barabbas? Yeah. Give us Barabbas. When I look at the story, I realize who Barabbas really is. That's me. That's you. still Jesus. It'll always be Jesus.
Hurry!
It'll never stop being the power of Jesus. If his blood is sufficient for your salvation, his blood is sufficient to sustain you through every challenge and every sin and every temptation. Jesus is
Jesus.